Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. Please excuse my appearance and my voice. I got back from LA and Vegas yesterday, severely jet lagged, and I've never talked so much in my life, so I'm slowly dying. But I thought it might be an easy and fun opportunity. No, I thought now would be a good time to try some products that have gone viral on the internet, mainly on TikTok, of course, and just give you my honest opinion. Two of these I've already used, and a couple of them will just be my first initial impression, because they are products that I feel like you get a pretty good idea just with a first impression. So you can probably see, I don't know how you can see it, I'm wearing a lot of makeup, a very pale amount of a lot of makeup. I don't know what I'm saying, I'm so tired. On purpose, because I want to try the BYOMA Melting Balm Cleanser. Now, this is a cleansing balm that contains barrier lipids, so good for damaged, irritated skin, to help your skin along with its natural healing process. Grapeseed oil and olive fruit extract for a nice oily cleansing experience. Now, I have opened this up. I must say, first of all, I am a fan of BYOMA's packaging. At first, I was a bit like, but do what I love about this is it packs away so easily. It's all like square. Have I got more of their products in the bathroom? So you can like stack them on top of each other. They like go away in a drawer or cupboard so nicely because it's just square with flat surfaces. So they stack and they compact. It looks like any old cleansing balm, a little bit menthol actually, hang on. We also have sea buckthorn oil in here as well, so we're gonna be nicely moisturized. Niacinamide to help with sebum production. You know, it's not menthol, I think it's the rosemary, like it's a little bit, I don't know, but think about it. It's the rosemary, which is an antioxidant. So let's see, here's my initial thing, first of all. We're in this square packaging and it's round like that. So I'm guessing all this is just empty space round here. And the packaging is just kind of like, you know, like a tube that comes down. Oh, it is extremely soft. I like that. I do not like to have to really work to melt down my cleansing balm. You know, you're left with all those like bits of balm that won't melt. So you kind of have to do this and melt those individual like little stacks. Yeah, melts down perfectly. The more I'm sniffing it, the more I can smell that rosemary. I quite like it, I'm not gonna lie. It's a little bit Sunday lunch, but I like it. Sounds really good, and it's just like they say, like buttery soft, like it's gliding over the skin. Does anybody else just get eyelashes everywhere all the time? Okay, I'm gonna go rinse this away and let you know my final thoughts. Okay, so face is clean and makeup free, and I absolutely loved that, to be honest with you. It emulsified not so much, but you know, it kind of turned into that whitey milky fluid that rinsed away so effortlessly and so easily. It's a really, really nice cleansing balm. Is it like better than any of the others? I do much prefer the texture, to be honest with you, rather than that plasticky feeling, balmy texture. I do think it's going to be one of my preferred cleansing balms, to be honest with you. So yeah, nice one. Next up is the Rhode Glazing Milk Ceramide Facial Essence. Now, I have obviously used all of Rhode's products. They were gifted to me. This wasn't gifted to me. I think I'm off their PR list for several reasons. And I have used this a fair few times. Whilst I can take or leave a few of their other products, the Rhode Lip products are probably their breakout product. Like, they are so good. And honestly, one of my favorite lip products of all time. They made such an amazing lip product. This has to be probably my second favorite product from them. That's not to say I'm in love with it. First of all, I need a little bit of extra hydration than this can give me. So I'm just going to spray myself with the Jordan Samuel Skin Hydrate the Mist. This isn't included in this viral thing. This is just one of my favorite products. Or you can just use this on like wet skin after you've cleansed. So they say that the glazing milk is a nutrient-rich, lightweight essence that boosts barrier function and provides immediate luminous hydration. Hailey's essential prep step to calm skin and being the Rhode routine. And begin the Rhode routine, right? They say it provides all-day hydration. I wouldn't agree with that. It provides nice hydration, preps skin for better product absorption, helps reduce the appearance of redness over time. I also wouldn't agree with that. That's only with about 3 weeks usage, I will say. Helps calm and soothe irritated skin. I will agree with that. Key ingredients are Ceramide Trio to help with the barrier function, beta-glucan, polysaccharides that help lock in moisture and calm skin, magnesium, zinc, and copper blend to defend against free radicals for plump, healthy looking skin. Now, this does have a very nice milky texture that is a little bit thicker than your like Korean milky texture. And that's one thing I will say. I think a lot of people on TikTok are getting a little bit overexcited about this, or they just have never used a milky toner before, because it is a nice milky toner. I do think Astora, for example, make a nicer one that does have kind of better hydrating benefits. But as for calming and soothing the skin, I would definitely say that this does. I didn't take this to LA with me, and the 2 days that I've been back from LA, I have been using this. And, you know, I was drinking, I was eating a lot, I was exposed to a lot of sun and stuff, and this toner... This toner has been supplying me with some pretty instant relief, and it makes your skin look really fucking good. It makes your skin look really dewy and really, really hydrated. And whilst that hydrating look and feel doesn't really last all day, I do think that the long-term benefits of this milky essence are definitely there. For me, as someone with oily skin, it's a little too thick for this essence toner stage for me. I do like a thick kind of like full fat water kind of toner. But as someone with an oily T-zone, I probably wouldn't want to layer this up with a moisturizer, because my T-zone went crazy when I did. For about a week, I was using this with a moisturizer and of course a sunscreen, and it was a little bit too much going on for my T-zone. But I'm loving this as just like a morning thing. Cleanser, this, a very light moisturizer, or I'll skip it completely and just use a lightweight sunscreen, and my skin is okay. My skin's a little bit destroyed from my LA trip, but do I think this is gonna help it? I absolutely do. It's been doing a great job so far. So whilst I do think this isn't the best milky toner out there, as I mentioned, there are Korean alternatives that I think are much more affordable for a lot more. You also get lighter weight milky toners, which do essentially the same thing. I do think this is a really, really good one if A, you want to support the brand, and 2, you have slightly drier, dehydrated skin. I really think you'll love this. I'm going to finish it up. Would I buy another one? I think I actually would, to be honest with you. This and the lip product, I think, are probably the best products from their full range. So on that note, I'm not going to moisturize, but what I do want to do is take a look at this. This is Hydromer by a brand called Slurp Laboratories. Now, you know I'm not a makeup person at all, but I've really been into trying to use a bit of a like cushion compact for my rosacea, just for those days where I really, really do look kind of like really, really red, and I just want to tone that down a little bit. I never fully want to get rid of my rosacea, because I tried this cream before, which did do it, only temporarily, and I look dead. I looked so like one color, I looked flat and I didn't like it, and I actually missed my rosacea. But one thing I hate about them is they leave my skin looking pretty matte, even when they say that they're sheeny and stuff, they're not. And I also don't really know how to use a primer. So that's when I discovered this. Now, they call Hydromer a liquid bandage made of Jeju algae polymers developed to prevent flare-ups and congestion triggered by external irritants, while priming skin for smoother, longer-lasting sunscreen makeup finish with a dewy undertone. I'm gonna do it to one side of my skin and not the other one, but I will be applying a cushion compact on both sides so you can kind of see the benefits and the difference. So it's a very clear, goopy kind of liquid that when you put it on, you're just meant to spread it across your skin. Again, it smells a little bit minty. It's got that rosemary leaf extract or oil in it. I can't remember what one. You can see it more there. Like, look how shiny it is. Oh, I'm only going to apply it to one side of the face, aren't I? Okay, let's apply it to this side of the face. And I have been using this for a long time now. I'm actually halfway through the bottle, but using it in like both hot and cold weather, it's been both like amazing at kind of like keeping my skin feeling moisturized and like looking dewy under makeup, and not like... So I tried some other primers and they kind of just left me with this horrible matte, silky feeling to my skin, like finish, which I really, really dislike. And I kind of love that this purposely leaves you super, super dewy. I'm going to use the M Cosmetics SPF cushion, whatever one this is. An amazing product. I do just wish she wasn't in a cult. What's the side I had it on this one? Okay, so This is an SPF compact cushion, but I never rely on the SPF in these alone, but they are great for kind of top-ups throughout the day. And as you can see, it's a little bit sticky, which I like because my makeup, as someone who wouldn't feel confident enough reapplying throughout the day, I like this because it really does stay like all day. Okay, so I feel like this camera really, really doesn't do it justice at all. But it's got this really nice glow underneath compared to the other side. I think my lighting's definitely helping all my skin look really glowy, but it's also the way it lasts throughout the day. Whilst without this, my skin would just get a little bit greasy and dewy, I just have this constant, stable glow throughout the day. It's a glow, dewy glow, not an oily glow, and you can really, really tell the difference. But yeah, this is definitely worth the virality, worth people going crazy for, worth being sold out all the time, because for me, it's just like a nice, dewy glow in a bottle and a very beginner-friendly primer. Sorry, there's now drilling out there. The next product I'm going to use is this thing. What's it? Hang on. This is the Medicube AHR Booster H. Not the best name. Very confusing. And from my understanding, this is a skincare tool that slowly vibrates and is meant to help skincare products penetrate the skin better. I believe there's a few different settings, one for really lightweight products like the serum I'm going to use, and a few different techniques depending on, like, you're meant to do like round ones and higher vibration for thicker products. But I have been doing the small vibration. And I've seen people put products on the actual tool itself, which I honestly think is really stupid. So I just don't think you get an even coverage. So I like to put the serum on first and then vibrate it over. Now, level one is a very gentle vibration. And what I do is just do it very slowly like this. Now, I think the whole point of this, as I mentioned, is it's meant to help product penetrate better, meaning you get the most out of your products and kind of boosting its benefits. Do I know if the science behind this is real in any way? No, I don't. I'll be honest with you. Do I think my skin has been looking any better from this? No. I actually don't. I'm not doing this properly, by the way. I'm just going to do this to demonstrate how it works. What it did do, however, is break me out, which I guess means that's working because the products were able to penetrate more. I kind of give me this purging, I think. I don't really know what was going on. I don't think my skin looks any better for it. I have only been using it for just over a month. They actually sent this to me a couple months ago, I think it was now. So maybe with continued use, it might work better. I don't really know, to be honest with you. I do not think it's worth spending a lot of money on something like this, but if your skincare works, it works. I don't really think I need this serum to penetrate better. I think this serum was made to do exactly what it needs to do with use of my hands. If a product needed to penetrate the skin better, I feel like it would be made so in that way. I just don't find this like this needs to exist. I enjoy using it, I'll be honest, but I think my products work just fine with my hands. I think this is a very expensive luxury that feels nice, but other than that, I don't think it really did a lot for my skin. I'm indifferent, I would say, for now, but I do want to keep using it and see if it gives me like some, So I have two sunscreens I want to share with you. This is the Ultraviolet SPF 50 Plus Fave Fluid. This is an ultra light sunscreen. I'm just going to review this one quickly because I know I've talked about it before, but this reminds me very much of the really watery Japanese sunscreens. I don't know if you can see here, but it's very, very fluidy. Yes, this reminds me of those Japanese sunscreens, but not as alcohol-y. While they do smell kind of alcoholic, and almost like craft glue, like PVA glue, it's not as drying as those ultralight sunscreens. I think Biore did one. I'll put a picture of it here. That's like the perfect example of how light this sunscreen is. Almost like water weight, really light, but this leaves you super hydrated, feeling nice and dewy and glowy without stinging the skin, the eyes, or leaving you looking overly greasy in any way. Now, the product I really want to try is this Sunshine and Glitter Sunscreen Collection with Crayola. Now, this is a jazzberry jam. scented sunscreen. What the fuck is Jazzberry Jam? What does that mean? And this is eco-friendly, biodegradable glitter. Broad spectrum SPF 50, UVA, UVB protection, water resistant up to 80 minutes. Reef safe, supposedly, and paraben free. So I really hate glitter. Sorry, the dustbin men are here now. I really hate glitter with a passion. So I'd love to see how glittery this really is, the smell of it, and how long the glitter stays around. From what I saw, oh my God. That smells so good. Oh, it's like strawberry yogurt, but sweeter. And is it glittery? Kind of. Sorry, there's like sunscreen under my fingernails. It honestly just looks like strawberry yogurt with bits of like strawberry pip in it. Let's zoom in. I'm worried this may leave me a bit too glittery and I'm really, really gonna hate it. Oh, I could feel it's like grainy. Oh no. Is this a zinc sunscreen? It's not. So why is it so white? What's going on? As I spread this around my face, the strawberry is starting to smell like bread. Like a loaf of bread. Okay, the whiteness is gone. I'm going to put on a little bit more as is needed. There's not a lot in this tube, you know. It feels like mainly air. I look very greasy. Very greasy. And it's stinging my skin just a little, but my skin is a little bit irritated and impaired at the moment. Look, there's another eyelash. Yeah, it's starting to smell like sweet, like a sweet donut or something. It's gone from smelling sweet to almost a little bit savory. And you can see the glitter almost everywhere. Can you? I may just look shiny and greasy, but you know what? This is cute. I'm not gonna lie. This is really fucking cute. This one is exactly the same, but with blue glitter in. So you know what? If you have a child and you're trying to get them to wear sunscreen, it's a cute thing to do. Like, oh, like mermaid glitter or sparkly crayon. I think it's really fucking cute. My skin doesn't sting anymore, just a little bit. It smells like sweet toast. I don't hate it. I think it's fun. Would I personally wear this? Maybe if I went to a music festival, which is not something you'll ever see me doing because I don't like to do things. But I think it's cute. I mean, on camera, it does look like I've just splashed like paint splatters on my face. But no, this is cute. I think it's a really nice idea for kids. So yes, let me know if you've seen any of these viral products on TikTok and what you thought of them, or if you tried them for yourself in the comments down below. Am I still recording? I am, good. Personally, I think that they've been some good viral products. I've enjoyed them, if not thought they were okay. But yeah, let me know in the comments down below. You can watch some more product reviews here and some general light entertainment here. And I'll see you over there.